I'm Alan Whiting from outbacktravelaustralia.com.au. Today we're down at Heasman Steering and Suspension, where my expert mate Ben is going to take us through the tricky job of fitting new shoes to a Toyota Landcruiser. We're using Bendix shoes, which have got improved friction characteristics over the standard shoes. I'll do all the talking. Ben's going to do all the work, and in particular we'll note one tricky section that can make the job very difficult.
Remove the two mounting bolts and remove the caliper. Make sure to rest the caliper on something so the brake hose does not stretch or break. Place the match marks on the rotor disc and rear axle shaft, then remove the rotor disc. This will help during reassembly. Using pliers, remove the tension spring. Remove the shoe return springs. Remove the shoe strut with spring. Slide out the rear shoe and remove the rear shoe and adjuster. You can now also remove the lower side tension spring. Slide out the front shoe. Disconnect the parking brake cable from the lever. Remove the cups, springs and pins. Remove the clip. It may help to use pliers. Remove the pin and wave washer, then disconnect the parking brake cable. Using a screwdriver, remove the C washer and pin. Remove the park brake bell crank from the crank bracket. Remove the boot. Inspect the disassembled parts for wear, rust or damage. Measure the brake shoe lining thickness. The minimum thickness is 1 millimetre. Standard thickness is 4 millimetres. If the shoe lining is less than minimum or shows signs of uneven wear, replace the parking brake shoes. Measure the brake disc inside diameter. Maximum inside diameter is 211 millimetres. Standard inside diameter is 210 millimetres. If the disc is scored or worn, the brake disc may be machined to the maximum inside diameter. Using pliers, connect the parking brake cable number 2 to the bell crank with the pin and a new C washer. Apply high temperature grease to the adjuster, as shown. Connect the parking brake cable to the front shoe. Install the pins, cups and shoe hold down springs to the backing plate. Now Ben, this is a tricky handbrake setup at the best of times, but I believe this pin is absolutely critical if you get this in the right position.
That's correct, yes. Having it this way is the correct way. If having it this way is the wrong way, it can cause the brakes to lock up.
Right, so that would push the shoe out.
That would push the shoe out, yeah. And cause the brakes to burn out.
Ooh, nasty. Okay.
So we'll put it back to the correct position and connect the front shoe up.
Terrific.
Slide in the front shoe between the cup and the backing plate. Do not allow oil or grease to get on the rubbing surface. Then install the rear shoe to the tension spring. You can now install the adjuster between the front and rear shoes. Slide in the rear shoe between the shoe hold down spring cup and the backing plate. Using pliers, install the tension spring. Do not allow oil or grease onto the rubbing surface. Install the front return spring and then install the rear return spring. Align the match marks and install the rotor disc. adjust the parking brake shoe clearance, temporarily install the hub nuts, remove the hole plug. Turn the adjuster and expand the shoes until the rotor disc locks. Return the adjuster 8 notches and then install the hole plug. Install the rear caliper assembly and torque the 2 mounting bolts to 1050 kilogram centimeters. That's better. The new Bendix handbrake shoes are pulling up very nicely indeed.